I'm here today. It happened accidentally. Actually, I was not invited. I was, had some work in the university. So they just said something is going on like this. So I'm happy about the whole thing and the way the each of the speaker has presented themselves. And my question is, yeah, we do have an empowerment. I do agree with that. But the thing is, how do we procure that women are more put to harassment in court? And simultaneously, we are not able to restrict ourselves to use technology is a must. But the technology and the cyber crimes, they don't go hand in hand. We don't have enough, you know, it takes so much of time to deal with this issue. So I would like you to, since you have given me all the epics and all these things, so this advanced this thing, how do the women have to protect themselves? If
we are... It's a very, very important issue which we have flagged. Very important issue. In fact, yesterday only, Gunjan came to me, a girl who is fighting a divorce case with her husband. And she came to my office and she said, my husband has hacked my phone. He has hacked my sister's phone also. And what to do? So we immediately approached the crime against, the cyber crime cell. You can give these complaints in police stations also, local police stations. But police people generally tell you to go to cyber crime cell. So you have cyber crime cells all over the places. Every district has cyber crime cell. There's a police station in which a particular department has been earmarked for that. So you can get this information from Google. Where's the cyber crime cell? You go there, you give a complaint to them. And they will track your mobile and they will see where and how it has been hacked. And thereafter, they will be dealt with in the same way as a person who is following you, who is troubling you on the street is dealt with. Because if you see, you are teasing somebody on road, you are following somebody on road, you are disturbing somebody on road, you are harassing somebody on road, is the same as what you are doing through your mobile or internet. It's exactly the same. That is on road and this is through technology, through mobile and internet. So on road, if this happens, you can go to police station, and if it happens through mobile or internet, you can go to the cyber crime cell. And they're quite effective. The number of complaints we have seen, they get
it
back.
It takes so much of time to do that. See, once we have to go through all the process, it takes time and we say let go. We can't stop using the technology. Simultaneously, we say that let go. Now I have to report them. Is there any way out to deal with the things like we have a fast track courts for some issues like that? So something like that. Is the women of
this is the
Ministry of the Women is it planning like having a special cell for these type of things, because it's, if you think that it's a general matter where it can be referred to cyber crimes, yes. I've been there too when Mahendra Reddy was cyber commissioner. I filed a couple of complaints of my daughter and all. But it takes time, the time taken for that is very, the thing by the time, and sometimes I hear, even at home you're not safe when you're using your technology, webcams and all. So can there be any special cell for the women with cyber crimes? Thank you.
You're absolutely right. Criminal justice system lags. It is very, very slow, criminal justice system. And secondly, this is, police reforms have to be there. Police, like I said, generally say, chalta hai. It happens. They are from that background and upbringing also. But I'll tell you something, what we as lawyers do. We hardly approach the local police station. Because as you go up in the police hierarchy, you have more educated and dignified people. That is my experience. So what we do, any and every complaint, we immediately email the complaint to Commissioner of Police. Here also you have commissionary system. So what we do is, we do not go to local police station. We email our complaint to the Commissioner of Police. The website link is always there, address is always there on the internet. Once you give your complaint to the Commissioner of Police, then automatically it is forwarded to a joint commissioner of police. And from joint commissioner of police, they give a call to you from his office that we have received your complaint, we have forwarded your complaint to the local SHO of the area and we'll get back in 3 days. So that can expedite the whole system. That is what we lawyers do. That in fact we also can do. And never think that, oh, we have to go into the SHO, we cannot go to DCP, ACP or commissioner. Let me tell you, if you dial 100 number, take their mobile number, they have been told to respond to every call. They have been told that. And if you tell them, and if they write to their SHO, take action within 3 days, SHO ko to ji salam karna hota na, he has to do it. Because SHO is answerable to his boss. So always talk to the higher ups in the police. That I have seen and has worked. Right?